Welcome to the Photography News Show, where I bring you the best and latest news in the photography industry. Coming up today, we have the first pictures of the upcoming Tamron 35-150mm, a telephoto lens integrated into a smartphone, and much more. So, let's begin! Hey fellow photographers, it's Alessandro Carpentiero, travel photographer and gear expert from Italy, and I want to welcome you to episode number 15 of the Photography News Show. This is a weekly series, and if you're into photography gear, you should definitely subscribe to always stay on top of the industry. So, let's see what's new. Lens news. As I've reported a couple of episodes ago, Tamron is developing a very interesting lens, the 35-150mm F2-2.8. And this week, we have the first real-life images of it. This lens has, in fact, been shown at the WPPI in Las Vegas. And based on this image, I would say the lens is fairly chunky, something that has to be expected due to its wide aperture and focal length. There are still no details about its dimensions and weight, but if you want to have an idea, here's another very interesting picture where you can see the 35-150 next to the new version of the 28-75mm f2.8. Both these lenses will be made for full-frame Sony mirrorless cameras, and I hope I will review them as soon as they're out. Camera news. This week we have the EISA Awards, which recognize the best products in the photography industry. There are several awards based on the category, and the overall winner is the Sony Alpha 1, which won the Camera of the Year award. Other important awards to mention are the Best Advanced Camera, which went to the Nikon Z6II, the Best Premium Camera to the Canon EOS R5, and the Best Professional Camera to the Fujifilm GFX100S. It's nice to see different brands for each category, while something interesting to mention is that other important brands like Leica, Panasonic, and Olympus didn't make it to the list. If you want to see all the awarded cameras and lenses, feel free to take a look at the first link in the description after you're done with watching this video. Smartphone news. Do you know that 36% of professional photographers shoot some of their work on smartphones? This crazy stat came from a survey conducted by Suite 48 Analytics on almost 900 professional photographers. We would need a higher number of participants to have a more precise idea, but this still shows a trend, and my guess is that this number will get higher in the future. Personally, I'm someone that would never shoot professional work on a smartphone, but what if that's what the client wants? That's exactly what happened to me a couple of weeks ago when I filmed a segment for a commercial on my smartphone, which was specifically requested by the client, as that's the look they were going for. If you think about it, now that social media has a massive influence on society, and content like IG stories and reels are so popular, it makes sense for brands to reproduce that kind of visuals for commercials too. This doesn't mean that everything will be shot on smartphones in the future, but they will surely be used more in some scenarios. That's why smartphone manufacturers have to level up their game in terms of quality and versatility. And this week, we have an 85-200mm lens integrated into a smartphone. Specifically, Chinese manufacturer Oppo has developed a continuous optical zoom that will allow you to zoom in without any loss of detail. During the keynote presentation, the company showed the comparison between a standard phone zoom and their new one, and there's a noticeable difference in terms of details. Besides that, it also has announced a 5-axis stabilization on the sensor, with similar technology to the one we have on the latest mirrorless cameras. And even if you don't want to get one of their smartphones, this is still very interesting news, because it shows the trend of the market. So we will most likely see similar solutions from other brands in the upcoming future. Software news. This week, Adobe has announced a major update for Photoshop on desktop and iPad. The most noticeable improvements are that Photoshop on iPad finally has the healing brush, which is perfect to clean up skies and skins, and the magic wand for quick selections. While the improvements on the desktop version are related to the Sky Replacement tool. there are new skies available, a Get More Skies option, which will take you to the Discover page on your Adobe account, where you can download several sky libraries for free, from sunsets to night skies. Replacing skies is now common practice, especially to get more likes on social media. So the question of the day is, do you replace the sky in your photos? How do you feel about it? Personally, it's something that I never do in my photography, as I prefer capturing what's on the scene, and with my post-processing, I improve only what's there. The only cases where I allow myself to replace the sky is if I'm on a paid shoot and there is a terrible weather. But this is just my opinion. Let me know yours in the comments. Accessory news. In this segment, I normally present to you some interesting accessory to make your life as a photographer simpler. But with today's accessory, well, you'll get more style. I'm talking about the ATL, a watch inspired by the iconic twin lens reflex camera. It's an automatic movement watch filled with tiny details that recall the design of this famous camera. If you love both photography and watches, this might be the perfect one for you. Weird news. The imaging world can be at times weird. This week, we have a teen who bought a Leica camera kit at a garage sale for $15. He had no idea of what he bought, so he posted a question on a Leica Facebook group. And well, he's discovered that he got a Leica M4 together with four lenses, and the whole kit is worth $7,200. Call that a good investment.
I'm talking about this.
Rumors. The Sony a7 IV was supposed to be launched in mid-September, but a trusted source has reported to Sony Alpha Rumors that the camera should be launched at least in October, and that supplies will be limited for the first months. This news doesn't come as a surprise, given that the chip shortage has affected many companies during this year. It's reported that the situation should be back to normal in 2022, so let's wait and see. That's it for today. I really hope you've enjoyed this episode of the Photography News Show. Which news did you like the most? Just let me know in the comments below. If you've liked this video, please give it a big thumb up, subscribe to the channel and activate the notification bell. And make sure to share this video with your photography friends to let them stay on top of the industry. And remember, if you need help with your photography, I'm always here for you. You can DM me on Instagram or send me an email, and I will be always happy to help. So, thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you in the next one!